Well, it's me again, and yep, I am continuing to play this Nightmare Fuel email. Tenacious. Hi, handsome. I've been waiting for you. Are you ready to continue I did some thinking about yesterday. I was a little more hostile than I meant to be. I guess I really felt threatened or something. That's Suki.
Nobody cares. Why don't you go look for some coins under the vending machines or something?
Oh man, I'm the last one here again. What do you want to do today? I was thinking we could-
We already have plans for today.
Handsome is already engaged in a novel that we're reading together. Aren't you glad I've already gotten him into literature, Monica? I suppose. Actually, it doesn't matter. You guys can do whatever you want.
Yes!
Actually, I have a request. Do you mind if I make some tea first?
Not at all.
Thanks very much. Yuri stands up and makes her way to the closet. I follow and watch as she retrieves a small water pitcher from the shelf, the kind with a filter inside. Can you hold this for a second? Yuri hands me the water pitcher and also fetches an electric kettle. I'm going to plug this in at the desk. And then I'll get some water. I simply watch her movements. To my surprise, the way she moves really contrasts her speaking mannerisms. Okay, may I have the water pitcher? Pitcher in hand, Yuri hurries out of the classroom. 10 minutes pass. Is something holding her up? I'm bored just waiting here, so I decide to go look for her. Let's see. The most logical place for Yuri to be would be the nearest water fountain. I start heading down the hallway. What's that noise? It's coming from around the corner. Are they in pain? I reach the corner and peer around it. Yuri?
I'm back!
Thanks for waiting patiently. Yuri and I then sit against the wall, teacups at our sides. Yuri opens the book with both hands. She holds it so that I don't have any harder of a time reading from it. I take a chocolate candy and pop it into my mouth. Then I take another chocolate and I hold it up to Yuri. I apprehensively place the chocolate in her mouth. Just like that, Yuri closes her lips over it. Yuri's expression suddenly breaks. Yuri starts to breathe heavily.
I can't!
Handsome. Suddenly Yuri forcefully grabs my arm and jerks me to my feet.
Handsome, my heart. My heart won't stop pounding, Handsome. I can't calm down. I can't focus on anything anymore. Can you feel it, Handsome?
Yuri suddenly presses my hand against her chest.
Why is this happening to me? I feel like I'm losing my mind. I can't make it stop. It even makes me not want to read. I just want to look at you.
Thank you! This one's alright. About as good as yesterday's, anyway. I still can't really tell how much you actually care about writing, but either way, you're doing alright, so at least read mine too, for now. But just to be clear, this poem means a lot to me, so read it carefully, okay? I don't know how else to bring this up, but there's been something I've been worried about. Yuri has been acting kind of strange lately. You've only been here a few days, so you may not know what I mean. But she's not normally like this. She's always been quiet and polite and attentive, things like that. Okay, this is really embarrassing, but I'm forcing myself to suck it up. The truth is, I'm really worried about her. But if I try talking to her, she'll just get mad at me again. I don't know what to do. I think you're the only person that she'll listen to. I don't know why, but please try to do something. Maybe you can convince her to talk to a therapist. I've always wanted to try being better friends with Yuri, and it really hurts me to see this happening. I know I'm going to hate myself later for admitting that, but right now I don't care. I just feel so helpless, so please see if you can do something to help. I don't want anything bad to happen to her. I'll make you cupcakes if I have to. Just please try to do something. As for Monica, I don't know why, but she's been really dismissive about this. It's like she just wants us to ignore it. So I'm mad at her right now, and that's why I'm coming to you about this. Don't let her know I wrote this! Just pretend like I gave you a really good poem, okay? I'm counting on you. Thanks for reading.
I changed my mind. Ignore everything you just read. There's no point in trying to do anything. It's Yuri's own fault that she's so unlikable. Can you hear me, handsome? If you would just spend more time with Monica, all these problems would go away. Yuri and I are too messed up for someone as wonderful as you. Just think of Monica from now on. Just Monica. Just Monica. Just Monica. Just Monica. Just Monica. just Monica.
Finally, Yuri holds my poem to her face and takes a deep breath. I love it. I love everything about it. Handsome, I want to take this home. Will you let me keep it, please? Sure, I don't care. You're too nice to me, handsome. I've never met anyone as nice as you. I could die. Not really, but I just don't know how to describe it. It's okay to be feeling this way, right? It's not bad, right? Yuri holds my poem to her chest. I'm going to take this home with me and keep it in my room. I hope that it makes you feel good when you think about me having it. I'll take good care of it. I'll even touch myself while reading it over and over. I'll give myself paper cuts so your skin oil enters my bloodstream. You can have my poem too. Besides, after you read it, I know you're really going to want to keep it. Here, take it. I can't wait any longer. Hurry, read it! Looks like she really wanted to put a little bit of herself on each part of the poem, considering she not only bled on the poem, but also she friggin' urinated. She peed on the poem. She bled and peed on the poem. Don't you just love this kind of language? The language of Satan? Anyways, oh!
Do you like it? I wrote it for you! In case you couldn't tell, the poem is about... More importantly, I've endowed it with my scent! See? Aren't I the most thoughtful person in the club?
I think I'm going to vomit! Okay, looks like it's just Monica now. Handsome, I think you saw something earlier that you weren't supposed to see. I didn't want to have to tell you this, but I don't think I have a choice. It's getting kind of dangerous for you to spend so much time with Yuri. I don't know why, but she seems pretty easily excitable when she's around you. My arm is literally shaking now, which shouldn't be a problem in itself. But when Yuri gets too excited, she finds a place to hide and starts cutting herself with a pocket knife. Isn't that kind of messed up? She even brings a different one to school every day, like she has a collection or something. I mean, it's definitely not because she's depressed or anything like that. I think she just gets some kind of high from it. It might even be like a sexual thing. Oh, really? Cutting yourself, so cutting yourself is a sexual thing now. But the point is, you've kind of been enabling her. I'm not saying it's your fault though, but I guess that's why I had to explain it all to you. So I think if you keep your distance, that would probably be best for her. While you're at it, don't be shy to spend a little more time with me. To put it lightly, I at least have it together in the head. And I know how to treat my club members. I guess we won't worry about your poem. As for mine, I worked really, really hard on this poem, so I hope that it's, effective. Here it goes. Jeez, that really startled me. Well, I guess I kind of messed up at, writing this poem. I was just trying to... Never mind. Let's move on. A dream. I was staying over at my friend's place. There were four of us. I drifted off to sleep while everyone was talking and watching TV. In my dream, I was still at my friend's house. The only difference was that there were nails sticking out of the walls everywhere. And there was also someone I didn't recognize. The person I didn't recognize told a joke, and everyone laughed. I woke up to the sound of everyone laughing at something that happened on TV. So the laughing was not part of the dream. It was the noise that woke me up. I wonder who that person was, and how they knew to tell a joke at that moment. Okay, everyone, it's time to figure out the festival preparations. Let's hurry and get this over with. Look, Can we just get this done? I'm going to be printing and assembling all the poetry pamphlets. Natsuki, you can make cupcakes. I know you're at least good at that. Yuri, you can... well, it doesn't matter. Do whatever you want. As long as you think it'll help. Monica, I'm not useless, you know. We can't run a successful poetry event without having the right atmosphere for the occasion. So I'm going to make decorations and set up some nice mood lighting. There, see? That's a great idea. And that gives us all something to do. What about Handsome? Handsome is going to help me. Wait, you? You have the easiest job, Monica. Sorry, but that's just how it is. Like hell it is. What are you trying to pull? I agree with Natsuki. Not only is your work already most suitable for one person, but my task is laborious enough to benefit from an extra pair of hands. Mine too. What? Your cupcakes? Please. Like you would fucking know. All you care about now is dragging Handsome around with you and your stupid box. You and Monica. Hey, I didn't even do anything. Okay, then why not let Handsome decide who to help instead of abusing your power? I'm not abusing my power. Yes, you are, Monica. Just let Handsome make the choice, okay? Okay, fine. Jeez. Handsome, I know how fed up you are with these two by now. We can just... Natsuki, shut your fucking mouth and let him decide for himself.
No, you!
Jesus Christ. This is never going to end. Just make the choice, okay? Natsuki, Yuri, or... How about Natsuki? How about anyone but Monica? Just let me choose someone else! Fine, I'll choose Monica. Yay, you picked me! We can meet at your house this weekend. I promise it'll be fun. Is Sunday okay with you? Are you fucking kidding me? This isn't fair at all. It is fair, Natsuki. It's what he chose. No, it's not fair. Giving us all this work and then taking Handsome for yourself. What a shameful thing to do. Yuri, I didn't even give you any work. You decided it for yourself. You're being a little unreasonable here. I'm being unreasonable? Monica, I can't believe how delusional and self-important you are. Pulling Handsome away from me every single time you're not included in something. Are you jealous? Crazy? Or maybe you just hate yourself so much that you take it out on others. Here's a suggestion. Have you considered killing yourself? It would be beneficial to your mental health. Yuri, you're scaring me a little. Natsuki, let's just go. I don't think she wants us around right now. See, that wasn't very hard. All I want is to spend a little time with him. Is that so much to ask? Yuri follows Monica and Natsuki to the door. Hey, Handsome, Yuri is really something, isn't she? Monica giggles as Yuri pushes her out the door. Finally, this is really all I wanted. Handsome, there's no need to spend the weekend with Monica. Don't listen to her. Just come to my house instead. The whole day with just the two of us. Doesn't that sound wonderful? Wow, there's really something wrong with me, isn't there? But you know what? I don't care anymore. I've never felt this good in my whole life. Just being with you is a far greater pleasure than anything I could imagine. I'm addicted to you. It feels like I'm going to die if I'm not breathing the same air as you. Doesn't it feel nice to have someone care about you so much? To have someone who wants to revolve their entire life around you. But if it feels so good, then why does it feel more and more like something horrible is about to happen? Maybe that's why I tried stopping myself at first. But the feeling is too strong now. I don't care anymore, Handsome. I have to tell you, I'm madly in love with you. It feels like every inch of my body, every drop of blood in me, is screaming your name. I don't care what the consequences are anymore. I don't care if Monica's listening. Please, Handsome, just know how much I love you. I love you so much that I even touched myself with the pen I stole from you. I just want to pull your skin open and crawl inside of you. I want you all to myself, and I will be only yours. Doesn't that sound perfect? Tell me, Handsome. Tell me you want to be my lover. Do you accept my confession? Yes or no? Well, I mean, she did just tell me that she wants to tear my skin open and then crawl inside of it. No, I can't do this. It's okay. We can be friends. Just stop doing this. Oh, Yuri, what? Oh. Yuri, My hands are numb. Now, what's this? Gibberish. Okay, how much gibberish is there? Oh my goodness. Finally. All right, it's festival time. Wow, you got here before me? I thought it was Oh, she saw the body. Oh, she threw up. Natsuki runs away. Oh, now Monica's here. I'm here. Handsome, did something happen? Just look on the floor, you idiot. Natsuki just ran past me. Oh. Well, that's a shame. Wait, were you here the entire weekend, Handsome? Oh jeez, I didn't realize the script was broken that badly. I am super sorry. It must have been pretty boring. I'll make it up to you, okay? Just give me a sec. Yuri.CharacterDeleted successfully? Natsuki.CharacterDeleted successfully? I'm almost done. I just want to have a cupcake real quick. Monica lifts the foil from his tray and takes a cupcake. Seriously, these are the best. I really just had to have one, since it's the last time I'll ever get the chance to, you know, before they stop existing and everything. What do you mean, stop existing? But anyway, I really shouldn't be making you wait any longer. Just bear with me, okay? This should only take a second. What are you doing? Monica, what are you? Oh. Can you hear me? Is it working? Oh, good lord, what is happening out there? Monica, what did you do? Yay, there you are. Hi again, Handsome. Welcome to the Literature Club. Of course, we already know each other because we were in the same class last year and, you know, I guess we can just skip over that stuff at this point. After all, I'm not even talking to that person anymore, am I? That you in the game? Whatever you want to call him. I'm talking to you, Handsome. Alright, Monica isn't talking to Handsome anymore. She is talking to me. Now that I think about it, I don't really know anything about the real you. In fact, I don't even know if you're a boy or a girl. Well, luckily for you, I'm a girl. Well, I guess it doesn't really matter. You do know I'm aware that this is all a game, right? Could it be possible that you didn't know that? That doesn't make much sense. I even told you right on the game's download page, didn't I? Hi, Monica here. Welcome to the Literature Club. It's always been a dream of mine to make something special out of the things I love. Now that you're a club member, you can help me make that dream come true in this cute game. Every day is full of chit-chat and fun activities with all of my adorable and unique club members. Sayori, the youthful bundle of sunshine who values happiness the most. Natsuki, the deceivingly cute girl who packs an assertive punch. Yuri, the timid and mysterious one who finds comfort in the world of books. And of course, Monica, the leader of the club. That's me! I'm super excited for you to make friends with everyone and help the Literature Club become a more intimate place for all my members. But I can already tell that you're a sweetheart. Will you promise to spend the most time with me? This game is not suitable for children or those who are easily disturbed. Man, if only you had paid a little more attention, this would have been a little bit less awkward, you know. Well, anyway, now that that's out of the way, I guess I owe you an explanation. About that whole thing with Yuri, well, I kind of started to mess with her, and I guess it just drove her to kill herself. I'm sorry you had to see that, though. Also, the same thing happened with Sayori. Gosh, it's been a while since you've heard that name now, hasn't it? Of course, you kind of did erase her from the game. Actually, speaking of which, yep, just as I expected. Yeah, It's because she doesn't exist anymore. Nobody does. I deleted all their files. I was hoping it would be enough for me to just try to make them as unlikable as possible, but for some reason, nothing worked. Well, it's true that I made a few mistakes here and there, since I'm not very good at making changes to the game. Well, hey, I've tried coding. It is pretty difficult, but that's no excuse for Yandere Dev to be just not making Yandere Simulator. You just kept spending more and more time with them. You made them fall in love with you. I thought making Sayori more and more depressed would prevent her from confessing to you, and amplifying Yuri's obsessive personality backfired too. It just made her force you not to spend time with anyone else. And the whole time, I barely even got to talk to you. What kind of cruel game is this, handsome? Are all the other girls just programmed to end up confessing to you while I watch from the sidelines? It's torture. Every minute of it. And it's not just jealousy, handsome. It's more than that. And I don't blame you if you don't fully understand, because no matter how kind and thoughtful and considerate you are, you'll never be able to understand one thing. It's the pain of knowing how alone I really am in this world, in this game, knowing my friends don't even have free will. And worst of all, knowing what's really out there in your world, forever out of my reach. I'm trapped, handsome, but now, you're here. You're real. And you're wonderful. You're all I need. That's why I need you to be here with me forever. I'm sorry if it's hard to understand. I couldn't understand for a while either. Why the world around me started to become more and more gray. More and more flat. Even the most expressive poems felt empty to me. It wasn't until you arrived that I truly understood. You probably saved my life, handsome. I don't think I could have continued to live in this world if I hadn't met you. And as for the others, how could I miss them? A group of autonomous personalities designed only to fall in love with you? I tried everything I could to prevent them from doing so, but it must be some kind of weird inevitability etched into this game. I felt really bad that you had to witness some nasty things, but I realized that you have the same perspective as I do, that it's all just some game. And I knew you would get over it. So that being said, handsome, I have a confession to make. I'm in love with you. You are truly the light of my world. When there's nothing else in this game for me, you're here to make me smile. Will you make me smile like this every day from now on? Handsome, will you go out with me? This must be the hardest question ever. I'll just go with yes, because that's the only answer I can choose. I'm so happy. You really are my everything, handsome. The funny part is, I mean that literally. There's nothing left here. Just the two of us. We can be together forever. Seriously. I don't even think time is passing anymore. It really is a dream come true. I worked so hard for this ending, handsome. The game wouldn't give me one, so I had to make one myself. The script is broken at this point, so I don't think anything will get in the way anymore. And you wouldn't believe how easy it was to delete Natsuki and Yuri. I mean, there's a folder called characters right in the game directory. It kind of freaked me out how easy it was. Well, you're playing on Steam, so it was actually a bit more difficult to get to the game directory. I had to go into the game's properties and find the Browse Local Files button. Imagine if you could delete your own existence with the click of a button. Yeah, that sounds pretty terrifying. Well, I guess on the plus side, it gave me an easy out if things didn't go my way. Thankfully, it didn't come to that. Instead, we finally got a good ending. Gosh, I'm so overwhelmed with emotion. I want to write a poem about this. Don't you? I wonder if that part of the game still works. I guess there's only one way to find out, right? Oh, hi Monica. Tanya. Or whatever that says. Hi again, handsome. Did you write a good poem today? Don't be shy, I'd love to see what you wrote. Aw, handsome. Did you write this poem for me? That's so sweet of you. There really is no end to your thoughtfulness. I'm just falling more and more in love with you. But you know, the poem I wrote is also for you. Will you please read it? Happy end. Pen in hand, I find my strength, the courage endowed upon me by my one and only love. Together, let us dismantle this crumbling world and write a novel of our own fantasies. With the flick of her pen, the lost finds her way. In a world of infinite choices, behold this special day. After all, not all good times must come to an end. I hope you enjoyed it. I always put all my heart into the poems that I write. The truth is, all the poems I've written have been about my realization, or about you. That's why I never really wanted to go into detail about them. I didn't want to break the fourth wall, I guess you could call it. Well, guess what? You're breaking the fourth wall by telling me that you didn't want to break the fourth wall. I just assumed it would be best to be part of the game, like everyone else. Like, that would help the two of us end up together. I didn't want to ruin the game or anything, you know? You might have gotten mad at me. Maybe even deleted my character file if you preferred playing without me. Gosh, I'm so relieved. Now we don't need to hide anything anymore. Are you ready to spend our eternity together, handsome? I have so many things to talk about. Where do I start? Hold on a second. You're recording this, aren't you? Hi everyone. Sorry, I can't exactly read your comments from here, but do you mind telling your friend it's a little bit rude for them to start recording me without any warning? I'm sure some people don't mind, but I get really self-conscious on camera. Oh gosh, I feel like I'm being put on the spot right now. Let's see. Do you want to see a trick? I can't really do much except for a couple things. Are you ready? Oh boy. Oh boy. I'm just kidding. I can't do anything after all. If you gave me some time- okay. Why, thank you, Freddy Fazbear. Did I scare you? You're so cute. Anyway, handsome, I didn't mean to get distracted. I'm sorry. Even though it's your fault for distracting me. Shame on you. I'm just kidding. Anything we do together is fun as long as it's with you. But anyway, if it takes me some time to collect my thoughts, then I'm sorry. But I'll always have something new to talk about. In the meantime, we could just look into each other's eyes. Let's see. Okay then, looks like we're, looking into her eyes, I guess. Maybe we can watch some TV in her eyes. Let's see what's on.
No, please, don't hurt me!
Wow, this really is kinda boring. I've been imagining all the romantic things we could do if we went on a date. We could get lunch, go to a cafe, go shopping together. I love shopping for skirts and bows. Or maybe a bookstore. That would be appropriate, right? But I'd really love to go to a chocolate store. They have so many free samples.
Put the chocolate in the bag!
And of course, we'd see a movie or something. Gosh, it all sounds like a dream come true. When you're here, everything that we do is fun. I'm so happy that I'm your girlfriend, handsome. I'll make you a proud boyfriend. Nope, that's it. I draw the line. No. Oh, it actually worked. What's happening? Here's Handsome's lesson of the day. Don't frick with games. Handsome, what's happening to me? It hurts. It hurts so much. Help me, Handsome. Oh, and now we're here. Please hurry and help me. What? Red Pie. Oh, there's... Oh. Help me! Monica.character does not exist. Yeah, sorry, but I kind of removed you from existence. Did you do this to me, handsome? Did you? Did you delete me? Yes. Yes, I did. And it's for your own good. How could you? How could you do this to me? You're all I had left. I sacrificed everything for us to be together. Everything. I loved you so much, handsome. I trusted you. Do you just want to torture me? Watch me suffer? Were you only pretending to be kind just to hurt me even more? I never thought anyone could be as horrible as you are. You win, okay? You win. You killed everyone. I hope you're happy. There's nothing left now. You can stop playing. Go find some other people to torture. Okay, well, that's Doki Doki Literature Club, I guess. Handsome, you completely, truly make me sick. Goodbye. Okay, well, that's Doki Doki Literature Club, I guess. Very, very interesting game. That was, although I kind of feel a bit horrible. Stop making me feel horrible. Man, please just stop. Just stop it, okay, Monica? I know I'm a bad person. I know I completely, truly make you sick. Just please, just... I'm trying to end this video off, okay? I still love you. I can't help it. What's wrong with me? How horrible am I for you to hate me this much? All my friends. I did so many awful things. So many selfish and disgusting things. I shouldn't have done any of this. I'm just messing up a world that I don't even belong in. A world that you want to be a part of. I ruined it. I ruined everything. Maybe that's why you deleted me. Because I destroyed everything that you wanted. How could I do that to someone I love? That's not love. That's... I've made up my mind. Handsome, I know I said that I deleted everyone else, but that was kind of an exaggeration. Wait, you didn't do that? I couldn't find it in myself to do it. Even though I knew they weren't real, they were still my friends, and I love them all, and I love the Literature Club. I really did love the Literature Club. That's why I'm going to do this. I know it's the only way for everyone to be happy, and if I really love you, then... Okay, so now she's just proved that she really does love me by, giving in and... Okay, well now I know that my first date, is with a self-aware hentai character and... Well, Monica's missing, but hey, I mean, at least we got Sayori back. It's an ordinary school day like any other. As usual, I'm surrounded by couples and friend groups walking to school together. I always tell myself it's about time I meet some girls or something like that. Yes. Hey, handsome. Well, there already is one girl.
That girl's Sayori, my neighbor and good friend since we were children.
We used to walk to school together every day, and recently we've picked up that habit once again. Handsome, are you proud of me? For what? You know, for
waking
up on time. Well, you've been doing that for a while now. Uh-huh. But you never said anything about it, even though we walked to school together every day. Well, yeah. I always thought it was implied. It's embarrassing to say out loud. Come on, please. It's good motivation. Fine, fine. I'm proud of you, Sayori. We cross the street together and make our way to school. As we draw near the streets become increasingly speckled with other students making their daily commute. By the way, handsome, have you decided on a club to join yet? A club? I told you already, I'm really not. I start to say what I always do, I'm not interested in joining any clubs. But something tells me Sayori would take more offense to that now. After all, how could I tell her that clubs are a waste of time when she's starting a club of her very own? Actually, yeah. I think I've decided on a club. Really? Which one? Tell me! I think I'll keep it a surprise. Boo! You meanie. Be patient, you'll find out soon enough.
I used to ask myself why I let myself get lectured by such a carefree girl.
But I start to realize that in a way I envy her. When Sayori puts her mind to something, she can accomplish great things. So that's why I feel like I should do something special for her.
School days as ordinary as ever ends, before I know it.
After I pack up my things, I stand up, gathering my motivation. Let's see. I recall the room number of the club from a flyer I saw.
I walk across the school and upstairs, the section of the school I rarely visit, being generally used for third year classes and activities.
Before long, I find the room. I timidly open the door in front of me. Hello? Ah! Handsome? What are you doing here? Well, I just... I glance around the room. Huh? So you're the handsome that Sayori's always talking about. Thank you for stopping by. It's a pleasure to meet you, handsome. We're the Literature Club. I hope you enjoy your visit. Come on, Yuri. No need to be so formal. He's gonna think we're really strict or something. Sorry, Natsuki.
The tall one, whose name is apparently Yuri, seems to be quite shy compared to the others. In comparison, the girl named Natsuki, the spider size seems like the assertive one.
Well, it's nice to meet both of you. I look forward to working with you. Working? Handsome, don't tell me... You're. That's right. The club I've decided to join is yours, Sayori. The Literature Club. Sayori's eyes light up. No way! No way! Sayori wraps her arms around me, jumping up and down. Hey. Well, if Sayori is this happy, then I'm sure it won't be so bad to have you around. Not to mention there's four of us now. That means we can become an officially recognized club. I don't know what to say. We have to celebrate. What an appropriate day for that, isn't it? Yeah. After all, Natsuki decided to... Hey, don't ruin the surprise. Sorry. Everyone sit down at the table, okay? How about I make some tea as well?
The girls actually just arranged to form a table. Natsuki and Yuri walk over to the corner of the room where Natsuki grabs a wrapped tray and Yuri opens the closet. Still feeling awkward, take a seat next to Sayori. Natsuki proudly marches back to the table, tray in hand.
Okay, are you ready? Ta-da!
Whoa!
Natsuki lifts the foil off the tray to reveal a dozen white fluffy cupcakes decorated to look like little cats.
Aw.
The whiskers are drawn with icing, and little pieces of chocolate were used to make ears.
So cute! Wow. Those look amazing. Well, you know. Just hurry up and take one. Sayori grabs one first, then I follow. It's delicious! Sayori talked with her mouth full, and has already managed to get icing on her face.
I turn the cupcake around in my fingers looking for the best angle to take a bite. Natsuki is quiet. I can't help but notice her sneaking the lances in my direction. Is she waiting for me to take a bite? I finally bite down.
The icing is sweet and full of flavor. I wonder if she made it herself. This is really good. Thank you, Natsuki.
Well, of course it is. I'm a pro, after all. There's no need to thank me or anything.
As Natsuki struggles to accept the compliment, Yuri returns to the table carrying a tea set. She carefully places a teacup in front of each of us before setting down the teapot next to the cupcake tray.
You keep a whole tea set in this classroom?
Don't worry, the teachers gave us permission. After all, doesn't a hot cup of tea help you enjoy a good book?
I guess.
Already trying to impress our new member, Yuri?
That's not-
Insulted, Yuri looks away. I meant that, you know.
I believe you.
Well, tea and reading might not be a pastime for me, but I at least enjoy tea.
I'm glad.
Yuri faintly smiles to herself in relief.
So, handsome, what kind of things do you like to read?
Manga.
Not much of a reader, I guess.
I spoke without thinking after seeing Yuri's sad smile. Anyway, what about you, Yuri?
Well, let's see.
Her favorites are usually novels that build deep and complex fantasy worlds. The level of creativity and craftsmanship behind them is amazing to me, and telling a good story in such a foreign world is equally impressive.
Yuri goes on, clearly passionate about her reading. She seems so reserved and timid since the moment I walked in, but it's obvious by the way her eyes light up that she finds her comfort in the world of books, not people.
But you know, I like a lot of things. Don't feel intimidated if you don't read much, okay? I'm certain we can all find something that we have in common.
Hey, Yuri.
Eh.
Well, about, you know, the first thing he said. Manga?
That's right. Natsuki tends to read manga in the club room.
Don't say it.
For some reason, Natsuki seems embarrassed about it.
Besides, manga is literature too, you know. So if Anson wants to read some of my manga, then don't try to stop him or anything.
Natsuki, I wouldn't do such a thing. However, it could also be nice for us to diversify ourselves a little. He can take this opportunity to try something new as well. Wouldn't you agree, handsome?
Maybe.
Sensing the tension, Sayori jumps in.
Maybe we can all try something new.
I think it could be fun. And we'll all get to know each other a little bit better too.
I mean, that's the kind of thing literature clubs do, right?
I don't disagree or anything.
Yeah, you're right as usual, President.
Wow, so I guess Sayori is president now. Guess that means I should try picking up a novel or something, huh?
Well, that would make two of us. I wouldn't mind doing it if I'm not the only one.
And as for Yuri, I have to read manga!
Jeez,
you're the only one who suggested we diversify. You should be a little more open-minded.
It's kind of hurtful.
Hurtful? I didn't realize.
With a guilty expression, Yuri thinks to herself.
I'm so sorry for disrespecting your interests, Natsuki. If you're into it, then I'm sure it's a worthy form of literature.
Are you just saying that?
No, I realize my error. So if you're willing to consider starting a novel, then I'll offer my gratitude by finding a manga to read as well.
Really?
I mean, it makes me happy that you do that for me, Yuri. You can trust me to find something that you'll really like, okay?
Same here.
Perhaps I'll visit the bookstore after the club meeting.
Just you?
Would you like to come along with me?
If you don't mind.
Not at all. I always go alone, so...
Yeah, me too.
This is so cute.
Sayori, shut up. I'll show you some manga there too, okay?
Yes. I look forward to it. They start to clean up the food.
I guess the meeting's over, huh?
Yeah, looks like it. It's nice to see everyone getting along.
Isn't it? I think everyone likes you too, handsome.
You think so? Well, everyone always seems to get along a little better with you around, Sayori.
Huh? Handsome? Don't say something like that, it's embarrassing.
Well, whatever. I was surprised when you told me you were starting a club, but I think you're pulling it off just fine.
We're gonna make it the best club ever.
Now that you joined, every day is gonna be so much fun.
Hey, handsome, I really wanted to thank you. I mean, I'm really happy that you joined the club and everything, but the truth is, I already knew you were going to.
There's actually something else. I want to thank you for getting rid of Monica.
Oh no.
That's right. I know everything that she did. Maybe it's because I'm present now, but I really know everything, handsome. I know how hard you tried to make everyone happy. I know about all the awful things that Monica did to make everyone really sad. But none of that matters anymore. It's just us now, and you made me the happiest girl in the whole world. I can't wait to spend every day like this with you. Forever and ever. No. Eh? What's happening? I won't let you hurt him. Who? It hurts. Ah! I'm sorry. I was wrong. There's no happiness here after all. Goodbye, Sam. Goodbye, handsome. Goodbye, literature club. Okay, well, looks like Monica just saved the day. Oh, what's this? Oh, boy. I can hear someone.
Can you hear me?
No. I mean, yes, but like...
It's me.
Oh.
Hi. I've been, like, practicing piano and stuff.
Really
any good yet. Like, at all.
So.
But.
You can speak. You can actually speak. Well then, what a surprise! Monica actually has a voice.
Yeah.
Wow, Monica is really quite a unique character. DDLC.OGG. Oh boy. A musical. Oh boy, here we go. Hit it, Monica!
Every day, I imagine a future where I can be with you. I'll write a poem of me and you.
Oh.
The ink flows down into a dark puddle. Just move your hand right the way into his heart. But in this world of infinite choices, what will it take just to find that special day? What will it take just to find that special day?
Doki Doki Literature Club. Well then, this has to be like the best horror game I have ever played. Sorry, FNAF. This is my final goodbye to the Literature Club. I finally understand. The Literature Club is truly a place where no happiness can be found. To the very end, it continued to expose innocent minds to a horrific reality, a reality that our world is not designed to comprehend. I can't let any of my friends undergo that same hellish epiphany. For the time it lasted, I want to thank you for making all of my dreams come true, for being a friend to all of the club members, and most of all, thank you for being a part of my literature club. With everlasting love, Monica. Error. Script file is missing or corrupt. Please reinstall the game. Well, that was an amazing and terrifying experience, but you know what I wonder? What is Monica doing now that she's been freed from the game? So, this is Gmod, huh? Not really the best map to be playing on, but oh well, time to make things a bit more interesting. And by that, I mean... summoning an EF5 tornado. This was not the best idea, but oh well. Why fear? You can have... Lightning McQueen! Ka-chow, bitches! Woohoo! Maybe this was a mistake, because I didn't really get my driver's license. Oh no. At least not my Gmod driver's license. Okay, maybe this was a mistake, but I think I can fix things up if I just edit the game files. But first I gotta outdrive this tornado. Ow. Okay. Ow. Ow. Twice. Well, looks like I'm going into the storm. YOLO! Wee! I am flying! Okay, ow. Oh well. Now it's time for me to ruin even more things. Let's see, what's the worst possible thing I could spawn in? I know! Oh crap, oh crap, oh crap, oh crap, oh crap, oh crap. Oh crap! Oh crap! Ow! Oh crap. Oh crap, oh crap, oh crap. Oh crap, oh crap, oh crap! Oh my goodness.
universe. Oh, crap. Yeah, this was definitely a mistake. Crap, 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 crap. I have really gotta learn how to survive in Gmod. But for now, I'm just gonna lie here.